The second round of aid delivery to typhoon-stricken Siargao Island hits a snag. That's after the barge carrying trucks of relief goods skidded on the way to the affected communities.
Until today, nandyan pa rin. So, with the help of Coast Guard, we'll try to bring another LCT para mailipat yung mga cargo para pag nagaan na yan, baka makaplot siya. Bigas, canned goods, nandyan lahat. This will be our second round of distribution.
Okay.
Kasi all over the municipalities sa Siargao, naka-distribute na tayo lahat.
Meanwhile, over in Surigao City, officials say they have received almost 8,000 food packs, more than 2,000 sacks of rice, and thousands of canned goods. Over 30% of Bohol's power supply has now been restored, more than 1 week since Typhoon Odette battered the province. Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi says they are still working on getting the power back in other areas. He also appealed to oil companies to remove the selling limit on petroleum products and open up more gas stations in the coming days.
Kausap ko rin po ang lahat ng oil companies, Shell, Petron, Phoenix, Uminoil, lahat po yan. We will ask the oil companies to increase the delivery of the petroleum product to the province. To the LGU, you will also help that yung others, sarado pa, the other na yung gas station na sarado pa na pwede magbukas na rin.
President Rodrigo Duterte, meanwhile, tasked the Interior Department to lead in the aid distribution in typhoon-hit areas during last Thursday's command conference in Cebu. It was only aired by the state news channel over the weekend.
So, shortcut na lang ako. The money will be distributed by the military. Si General Anyo will supervise yung areas na kagaya ito, highly urbanized, ano naman lahat, diretso na sa total from the military, it would go to the LGUs. But yung lugar na medyo wala masyadong presence ang gobyerno. Again, it will be the military who would be there to say that the money.
COVID-19 infections in the country once again on the rise amid the flurry of holiday gatherings. The Okta Research Group says that in Metro Manila alone, the COVID-19 reproduction rate is now at 0.70%. That's almost double from the previous 0.42% reported back in December 15. There's also an increase for a third straight day in the number of people testing positive for the virus nationwide. But so far, the country's positivity rate is still within the 5% benchmark set by the World Health Organization. The number of active cases in the Philippines also went up for a fourth straight day. That's after the health department logged 433 new infections Sunday. But so far, hospitals are not yet feeling the strain. 13 more had died, pushing the death toll to 51,200. 283 patients, meanwhile, recovered. Surging COVID-19 cases in the U.S. forced hundreds more of flight cancellations across the country over the Christmas weekend. More in this report.
Hundreds of flights were canceled across the U.S. for a third day over the Christmas holiday as surging COVID-19 infections grounded flight crews. Commercial airlines canceled more than 700 flights in the U.S. on Sunday, nearly 1,000 on Christmas Day, and about 700 on Christmas Eve, according to a tally on flight tracking website FlightAware.com. Further cancellations were likely, and more than 1,400 flights were delayed. The rapid spread of the Omicron variant has led to a sharp increase in COVID-19 infections during a peak travel time, forcing airlines to cancel flights with pilots and crew needing to be quarantined. Delta Airlines expected more than 300 of its flights to be canceled on Sunday due to the virus and winter weather. FlightAware data showed more than 2,000 flights were called off around the world on Sunday, and at least another 7,000 were delayed. Omicron now accounts for nearly three-quarters of U.S. COVID-19 cases and as many as 90% in some areas like the Northeast. New U.S. coronavirus cases have risen 45% over the past week, according to a Reuters tally. While recent research suggests Omicron produces milder illness and a lower rate of hospitalizations than previous variants of COVID-19, health officials remain cautious.
The Philippines receives more supplies of COVID-19 vaccines. 1.9 billion doses of AstraZeneca jabs procured by the government arrived in Manila Sunday, bringing the total number of COVID vaccines delivered to the country to more than 200 million doses. Of that figure, over 100 million shots have already been administered. This latest shipment comes as the government resumes inoculations following a three-day Christmas break. Authorities aim to vaccinate 54 million Filipinos by the end of the year. Only about 44 million have completed their doses as of December 20th.